For each of the scenarios below, determine how the total mass. Determine how the total mass of the described object or system is changing and place in the appropriate bin. We have six of those situations here, scenarios, and we need to place them inside of each of these bins to choose where to place them. We have increasing mass, decreasing mass, and unchanging mass. This is about relation between mass and energy, rest mass and energy, so to speak. So, according to Mr. Einstein, E is equal m times c squared, where m is rest mass of the system of the object, E is energy, and c is speed of light. Speed of light is constant, and that is 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. When will we have a situation that mass increases? When we take in the energy from the environment, therefore mass increases. Let us see down there, a spring being slowly compressed. A spring being slowly compressed, that is taking the energy from the environment. What does it mean? That means when you have some unstretched spring here, it has some rest mass, but if you squeeze that spring, applying outside force or forces, you will have to work against elastic forces of the spring and you will increase its mass. Why? Because there is increase in energy of the spring. Energy is increased, so mass has to increase also, according to Mr. Einstein. So unstretched or undeformed spring left of the table on the own have the smallest mass possible. But if you stretch or squeeze it, you need to invest work against that spring and you will increase its mass according to the situation. Why slowly? That is story for something else. Decreasing mass. If you're losing energy to the environment, you will have decreasing mass. That will be, let's say, a hot stone cooling down. A hot stone cooling down will lose its energy to the environment. So, its energy will decrease. And according to this equation here, if the energy decreases, mass will decrease also, because the speed of light is constant. Energy decreases, mass of the hot stone will decrease also. The decrease in mass is very small. It cannot be measured directly with our equipment, but it exists. Decrease in mass is evident in nuclear reaction, because nuclear force is very strong, so it's easy to see there. What about the unchanging mass? But if we have isolated system that is isolated from the environment, then its mass will remain constant. Like this one. A closed thermally isolated box containing a controlled exothermic chemical reaction. But look at this. Thermally isolated. That means all energy is inside the box. All energy is inside the box. There is nothing is lost or gained in from the environment, or nothing is lost to the environment or gained from the environment. So that means that energy inside that box, thermally isolated box, is sonst. That mean mass is sonst also. That mean it doesn't change. Unchanged mass. So we will take this situation here and place it in this box here. Now you have three more. For complete written answer, please follow the link in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Bye.